We're here today with Oak Park Mayor Marion McCullen, who is running for re-election this year. How are you doing today?
Couldn't be better. Thank you, Crystal.
Thank you for coming. Can you talk a little bit about how long have you been mayor for and what are some of the successes been?
I was elected in 2011, so I've been mayor for almost 6 years. And things were pretty tough when I took over. It was the worst financial situation that the city had ever seen. They weren't a city during the Great Depression. And the finance director said, we've never been in this bad financial crunch. Welcome to municipal government. And so now, instead of worrying about going into work, I can't wait to see what the next wonderful news is. So it's just been a blessing. We started an economic development department, and it's been very successful. They found us Federal Express to take over the former Armory property, going up to 400 jobs, huge, enormous 300,000 square foot facility, very, very automated, and it's paying taxes now, so that's always happy news for a city. Then we got the biggest and best Planet Fitness in their local chain here. That's bringing everyone together, everyone from surrounding cities and all parts of our city. It's just been a little United Nations spot. We got a TAP grant for fixing Nine Mile Road, and work should start in the coming spring. Economic development always takes more time than I want it to take. I want it Tuesday, but it is coming, and we're going to be narrowing Nine Mile Road because it is, since they built 696, the widening of Nine Mile Road has been superfluous, and we're not just narrowing it, we're putting in bike lanes, we're putting in more parking, and Phase 3 is going to be putting in a wonderful little linear park there with places to sit and places for kids to play and hopefully dogs. And and speaking of dogs, we have the police department is reaching out to the community in amazing ways. Our public safety director, Steve Cooper, walks on water, in my opinion, and he's come up with so many ways of bringing the community and the police department together. So there's the academy where you can learn how to do fingerprints and look at a fake dead body for clues, and just wonderful, wonderful experience for the community. Then we're getting our first canine officer. Usually they're named after a deceased public safety officer, and Mason Samborski lost his life on the job, and in his honor, we're naming the dog Mace. And the kids in the neighborhood can't wait for Mace to come to the Oak Park Police. Also, they came up with the idea of an ice cream truck, because when do you see the policeman? You see him when he's giving you a ticket, right? And so this is a chance to see the policeman when he's handing you an ice cream sandwich and talking with you and being supportive. So that unit goes to community gatherings and goes up and down the streets to patrol, and if they see kids, they will pull them over and hand them an ice cream sandwich. And we were also told if the parents look sad, they'll give them an ice cream sandwich too.
Nice. What background do you bring to the mayor's position? What's your professional experience?
My professional experience was as a teacher for 32 years at many, many levels. I taught English as a second language. I taught in the city of Detroit, in Warren, and in Rochester Hills. A lot of people skills involved in teaching and dealing with parents and dealing with kids. And it seems to me that's the, and the idea that service to people is important. I think that's the connection between my past and my present jobs.
Now you're unopposed this round, correct?
Yes.
So let's just talk briefly. What do you enjoy about being mayor? Why are you doing this again?
I thought I was only going to run once, but I'm enjoying it so much because I can see so much growth and change and improvement in the city. The Sunflower Project was a small financial project with a big payback. People just loved it. And people from all around came to Oak Park and loved seeing the sunflowers, kind of a symbol of hope and cheer and growth, and that new things are happening in Oak Park. I think it sends a message that it's not your daddy's old Oak Park anymore. We're doing what old Oak Park was famous for, which is innovating and coming up with new ideas and being a city that other cities are looking to for ideas. And our communications department is rocking and rolling. It sort of was not something to be proud of in the past, and now other cities are coming to us and telling us that they're using ideas from our monthly mayoral emails and the booklets that we put out. This will take a little. Here's a winter. Here's a spring. This is So we've upped our game, and we're not done. And it's just too much fun. I enjoy working with people. Usually, no one calls the mayor unless they have a pretty good head of steam up. They're upset about something. Think about, you know, if you've ever called a mayor in the past. So they have some legitimate thing that they're really concerned about, and I can help them. And I don't mind the complaints. If they didn't care, they wouldn't be complaining. And I like working with people and making everyone feel that they're an important part of our city, which they are.
So what's next on the horizon in your next few years? What are some of the issues or the challenges that you want to take on?
Challenges are always financial. And if you have a lot of time, I'll explain the way cities are funded through the state.
But, all right. Our readers already know about municipal funding. Financing, we're good on that. Yeah.
Okay. So doing exciting new things when the funds keep getting cut is a challenge for all the cities in Michigan. And similarly, it's our challenge. But we are excited about what's coming. And there are new things coming that they won't tell the mayor about, because if things aren't signed and sealed, anything can happen with economic development. But we're expecting some real good news in the next 6 months. We just did the grand opening of Jefferson Oaks, where they took an old school, and instead of letting it get all blighted with weeds growing up and boarded up windows, they are turning it into housing. So the school itself, the 1920s beautiful brick school, will be turned into apartments and a community center in the gym. And surrounding on the grounds, there will be townhomes built, beautiful 3 and 4 bedroom townhomes. A critical need in the state of Michigan and around the country, as you well know, is affordable housing. And so we have people who are working who can't afford a place to live. And I think it was Petoskey that a restaurant closed, not because they couldn't serve the food or the people didn't like it, but they couldn't get people to work there who could afford to live in the sort of upscale town. And it's a national problem, and we're starting to solve it here in Oak Park.
Now, I know with nobody running against you, I'm not sure if you have a website or not, but if people just have questions about you as a mayor or any of that, how can they get hold of you?
If it's a city question, they can call 248-691-7410. They can go on our new beautiful website that we're bragging about, and and leave a message or a comment. They can call the mayor. I give my cell phone number to everyone, 248-217-1883. Feel free to call with questions or concerns. You sometimes don't know who to contact in the bureaucracy, and I can direct you.
Well, thank you so much for coming out today.
Crystal, It's always great talking to you.